In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a custom Google Chat app with AppScript. Hi, I'm Chanel, a developer advocate at Google. In this video, we will build a chat app that manages your out-of-office tasks. The chat app will manage these three tasks: blocking out your calendar, canceling all meetings, and setting an out-of-office auto-reply. To follow along with this tutorial, you will need a Google Workspace account and access to the Google Cloud Console. For every step of the chat app creation, you can find a dedicated chapter in this video. Feel free to jump to whichever chapters interest you. For your convenience, we have made the code used in this video available on GitHub. Create the script and update script manifest. Since we are creating our chat app with AppScript, we are going to create a new standalone script. The first function we are adding is onAddToSpace. This function handles the event where a chat app is either added to a one-on-one conversation with the user or to a chat space. The function onRemoveFromSpace we add to the script for the event where a user removes the chat app from a chat space. The onMessage function is where we handle the user messaging the app. As you can see, we are using a switch statement to handle slash commands. We will add these four slash commands to our app configuration in GCP later in this tutorial. You might have noticed that the three functions make use of the event object that gets passed in as a parameter. This object contains information that we can use to do things like identify the chat app user or which slash command was invoked, and so on. When the user invokes the help slash command, our app will display a card with some information about how to use the chat app. To achieve this, we add the create help card function to our script, which returns the JSON representation of our card message. Since we are using the most recent version of card messages, we have to add the properties of cards v2 and card ID with an arbitrary string as a value. To handle the slash command block day out, we add the corresponding function to our script. This function calls the block out calendar function and returns the create response card function. Both we will add later to our script. To handle the slash command cancel all meetings, we add the cancel all meetings function to our script. To handle the fourth and final slash command, we add the set auto reply function. For two of our functions, we need the equivalent of 1 day in milliseconds. That's why we add the 1 day millis constant. The blockout calendar function creates an all-day event in the chat app user's Google Calendar. Currently, we can't add event types of out of office programmatically, so we are using an all-day event as a workaround. Next, we add the cancel meetings function that gets all of the day's meetings the chat app user has and then sets the status of not attending. The turn on autoresponder function turns on the out of office responder in the chat app user's Gmail. The last function we add to our script is that of create response card. This function contains the JSON representation of the card message used to inform the chat app user about the completion of the task they requested. To not have to create three separate card messages for each of our three tasks, we simply pass in the text as a parameter when we call the create response card function. We have to update the manifest file to be able to publish our app to Google Chat. To do so, we first have to make the file visible in the script editor. Add chat as property and an empty object as the key. Enable Gmail Advanced Services. To be able to turn on the out-of-office autoresponder, we need to enable the Gmail Advanced Services for our script. Later, we will also enable the Gmail API in the Google Cloud Console. Create Google Cloud Project. When you create a new AppScript project, AppScript creates a default cloud project that operates in the background. Now, for most scripts, that's the best option. But when you create a custom Google Chat app, we need to be able to manually configure the cloud project. That's why the next step is to create a new dedicated project in the Google Cloud Console. Create OAuth consent screen. For every Google Chat app, we have to configure an OAuth consent screen. Since we plan to use this chat app only within our Google Workspace domain, we choose user type internal. What we add under app information will be visible for the chat app users on the consent screen. You can provide additional information under the app domain section, like the link to your chat app's privacy policy, and so on. Make sure to provide an up-to-date email address so Google can notify you about any changes to your Cloud Console project. Since the app is only for internal use, there is no need to manually add any scopes for review. Now we add our newly created Cloud Console project's number to our AppScript project settings. Publish Chat App. At this point, we are ready to publish our app to Google Chat. We publish our chat app as an add-on, give it a description, and copy the deployment ID. We are going to need this ID in the next step when we configure the Google Chat API to establish a link between our app and the API. Enable Google Chat API. Next, we have to enable the Google Chat API in the Google Cloud Console. Once the API is enabled, we can start with configuring it. Set app functionality, connection, and permissions. On the Configuration tab, we add the necessary information about our app. In this tutorial, we are configuring our chat app to receive direct messages from users and that it can be added to group conversations or spaces. The deployment ID we copied in the script editor has to be added in conjunction with choosing AppScript project as connection setting. Add slash commands. We've designed our script to respond to four different slash commands. In the Google Chat API settings is where we can define these slash commands. For each slash command, we need to provide a name, which the user types in Google Chat, a command ID, and a short description. Make sure that the command IDs you define on this screen correspond to the ones your code will respond to. We'll define that everyone in our domain can use the chat app and save our configuration. Enable the Gmail API. Remember that we enabled the Gmail Advanced Services in our AppScript project? Since we exchanged the default cloud project with our newly created project, we have to additionally enable the Gmail API in the Cloud Console. Use the chat app. Now that our chat app is created, we can start using it. Since we configured our app to be available to everyone in our domain, I'm going to use Christian's account to demo it. Once the user installs the chat app, we can start typing the slash commands we defined. At this point, the chat app asks the user for permission to access their Gmail and Google Calendar. As expected, the block dayout slash command blocks out the day on the user's calendar. And the set auto reply slash command programmatically added an out-of-office responder in Gmail. The cancel all meeting slash command sets the status to no for the meeting invites of the user. If you've learned something new in this video, then please leave us a like. Want to learn more about Google Chat apps? Then check out the Google Chat for Developers documentation. There you will find easy to follow along samples to get you started building your own Google Chat apps. Subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos about Google Workspace development and AppSheet. Stay tuned for future videos where I'll share more about building Google Chat apps.